I think this project, led by RIT in collaboration with Raytheon, is going to develop new kinds of devices, new kinds of detectors for a lot of different applications. The key is that we'll be able to make big detectors, much larger than ever before. So instead of 10 megapixels or 20 megapixels, which is already big, we'll be talking about gigapixels, all-in-one detector. And this covers an immense field of view. Besides that, the detectors are ultra-sensitive, more sensitive than ones that are available today, which means the noise will be low, that salt and pepper pattern that you can see in low-light images, that'll be very low. So we could see faint galaxies, we could see other planets that are like Earth, maybe that harbor extraterrestrial life. Those kinds of applications demand the most sensitive detectors possible.
So at the end of the day, that's all we're doing, we're measuring how many photons. But how many photons is the answer to a lot of important questions. It's the answer to where's the exoplanet? It's the answer to where's the ozone hole? It's the answer to where is the cancer?
There are only a few places in the world that can do this kind of testing, and the companies who develop these devices, often for other purposes, can't do this kind of precision testing. So NASA and NSF have both independently funded us because for both of those, their needs, these detectors are very important. So that means missions in space that look out into the universe, but also on observatories around the world that would use these kinds of detectors. We're the lead organization, and so that means we're going to set the end goals and the plan for how to reach those goals.